ring, the team of the superstar Bill Dundee, his partner Jerry the King Lawler. Ladies and gentlemen, their opponent, the Colorado Kid. And his partner, let's welcome back to Nashville, the fabulous one, Jackie Fargo.
Well, Lee, this is when over 1,000 fans came out to the Nashville Fairgrounds Arena to witness a few short weeks ago. Jackie Fargo, Colorado Kid, against Lawler Dundee with Miss Stacy. And I know the fans here, look at that crowd, my gosh. I know the fans already know that we've signed a hair match on July 10th. We're going to show today why that match actually is taking place.
Now, Miss Stacy down there on the corner looking all pretty and stuff in that little gold. Jerry the King Lawler and the Colorado Kid in the ring to start it off. Jerry Lawler from the WWF. Him and Bill Dundee's got some history, Bert.
You better believe they all have history in that ring, I tell you what. Talk about legendary performers. I just wanted to mention something about Stacy. Stacy and myself on Sunday night, August 29th, all you folks who watch the pay-per-views, mark your calendar because Sunday night, August 29th, Stacy's going to be on the Dangerous Curves ladies pay-per-view, and I will also be on it, coming from the Riviera Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. It's called Dangerous Curves. Some people are calling it Puppies Galore.
Oh,
and
puppies.
There will be some of the greatest lady wrestlers in the world from the Riviera Hotel, Sunday night, August 29th, only on pay-per-view. You can see it, and I'm going to be hopefully a big part of it. I have some surprises, but I know Stacy's going to be there, and who knows in what capacity.
Will you take me, Bert, please?
Yeah.
Jerry Lawler and Bill Dundee now trying to get the crowd pumped up on their side. Lawler coming back into the ring, and Stacy's over there cheerleading.
Well, they're not going to get in Lawler's side. Jackie Fargo owns, controls, bought and paid for Nashville, Tennessee with his blood, sweat, and tears, and there's not a bigger living legend than the Jackie Fargo. What Hulk Hogan's legendary status to the World Wrestling Federation is, Jackie Fargo is to Nashville. And I tell you, what an incredible match it's going to be, because on Saturday night, July 10th, Fargo and Lawler in the ring one-on-one. All the rules change there. And of course, Stacy on the outside. And
Lawler now just knocking Jackie Fargo down, strutting around the ring. That's not something you're going to want to do to Jackie Fargo. The man's not all there.
No, he's still got the power of the punch, I'll guarantee you.
Now, this hair versus hair match, Bert. Jackie Fargo, like right there, crazy man. I like Jackie Fargo a lot, and in this match, I hope the man wins. But
Fargo's still got it, but I tell you what, Lawler wouldn't put his hair up. Lawler says, oh, no, here, I'll put Stacy's hair up.
I know, I hate that.
And, I think Stacy looked good, Balch.
I
go to Las Vegas with a butch haircut.
That wouldn't be good. Fargo and the Kid in the ring. Now, Jackie Fargo has a relationship with the Colorado Kid. The Kid needed a partner for Jerry the King Lawler, Superstar Dundee, picked up the phone, called Jackie Fargo, and without hesitation accepted.
Fargo's been, kind of a mentor to the Colorado Kid the last 3 years. He's helped him out a couple of times in some tight spots. And I tell you what, Fargo has always been there when he's made the call. And also that night on July 10th, we're going to have a celebrity barber there to shave the head of the loser of this match. So if Lawler gets pinned and I don't even know if Lawler knows this, if Lawler gets disqualified, Stacy's losing her hair.
I have to talk to him before he goes out and beg him not to lose. There he goes, hitting Jackie Fargo again. Fargo now down on the floor, celebrating in the room, high fives. Right, trying to mock Jackie Fargo in the center of the ring. Lawler and Dundee doing the strut.
Yeah. Well, Jerry Lawler, proud as a peacock right now, but I don't know if he'll be strutting on Saturday night, July 10th, because not only has Fargo put up his hair,
he's
put up $20,000 cash. And I tell you, Fargo did what he said he would do before. And there, just comes up behind Stacy.
It scared her to death. Did you hear that squeal? Sound like a mouse getting ran over or something.
They love Jackie Fargo in Nashville, Tennessee, I tell you what.
Jackie Fargo and the Colorado Kid teaming against Jerry the King Lawler, Superstar Bill Dundee, and the gorgeous Miss Stacy down on the floor. Now, Bert, Saturday night, July 3rd, this dog collar match between Chris Michaels and Bart Sawyer. Something is going to be settled here.
Yeah, it's going to be bloody. We got so many great cards coming to Nashville. We'll be out there the July 3rd with a big 4th of July weekend spectacular. Axel Rotten coming back to Nashville, take on Colorado Kid. Ladies night out, Bad Street Boys will be there. New South of Fans, Lumberjack with strap match. Air Paris, David Young. Bambi against Miss Angelica. Angelica's getting a heck of a following.
Angelica's a looker too.
Yeah, we'll be out there the 10th. And then, you know, the big one, you know, we're talking about hair versus hair. But then the big one is Saturday night, July 17th, Summer Blast 99. I'm kind of keeping that a secret right now.
You haven't told me anything yet.
The great thing about the, especially July 3rd, all kids will be admitted free. Mom and dad bring, I don't care if you bring 6 kids, 10 kids, the kids get in free. Now don't come out and drop your kids off, and you know, we're not going to babysit the kids, but if you bring the neighborhood gang, that's fine with me. Bring the kids, and kids, no charge, general admission seats. All night long, Saturday, July 3rd. Also on that big card, Hair versus Hair, on July 10th, there will be no increase in ticket prices for any of the July events. So ticket prices are staying low, and I tell you what, we're going to have a great time in the month of July at the Nashville Fairgrounds, the home of NWA Worldwide Wrestling. Boy, I tell you, the fans are getting in on this. Lawler's insulting everybody just like he always does.
That's one. I guess that's the thing Lawler does best is run his mouth, insulting the fans. Two ladies now trying to get to Lawler and Stacy.
There's Miss Myra down there, Myra Guthrie. I tell you, if she gets a hold of Lawler, Lawler would be knocked to the ground, because if Myra could pack a punch, let me tell you that.
Yeah, I think she wanted to get a hold of Bart Sawyer, too. There's Stacy getting up on the ring. There he is, insulting the fans again.
Yeah.
He always insults the people of Nashville, just like Bart, but you know, we're not going to talk about Bart now. The Colorado Kid and Axel Rotten from ECW. This match just has Extreme written all over it.
Yeah, it's going to get a little wild. Look at the crowd here at Nashville Fairgrounds. I'll tell you, the local media was out there in full force. Several other TV stations were there. Of course, the British people were there. You see cameras all over the place. This one got out of the referee's control several times, and you're seeing one of these stretches right here. Right now, we're going to take a break, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll be back. And you won't miss a thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the action. I'm Lee Tidwell, alongside me, Bert Prentice, the fabulous one, Jackie Fargo, coming into the ring, taking on superstar Bill Dundee.
I tell you what, talk about two legends in the ring. And Fargo came to fight, didn't he?
Fargo came to fight. He's chasing all of them around, even coming after Miss Stacy, threatening to pull down her pants and spank her butt.
Lee.
Well, I wanted to see it.
The family show. Knock it off.
Puppies. Anyways, whips him off the rope. Dundee just keeps. Dundee's not too smart. His old age is showing. Alzheimer's and stuff, running back and forth, going to wear himself out. There he goes. Falls down. Fargo with the cover. Jimmy Rivers, one, two, oh, two and a half there on Bill's Dundee. Jackie Fargo almost got the victory.
Do you know how many thousands and thousands and thousands of tickets Jackie Fargo has sold to a wrestling match in Nashville, Tennessee? I mean, you are absolutely watching a living legend at work. Jackie Fargo and Jerry the King Lawler, another young man who sold out more arenas in the Mid-South probably than anybody else.
Well, if you could get a penny off each ticket Jackie Fargo and Jerry Lawler sold, you'd be a millionaire now.
Oh, absolutely. And you know, it's great that we can bring this great Southern tradition, especially in this day of whatever they call the wrestling, that we can still bring some Southern brand style of wrestling to these folks. And let me tell you, later in this match, something happened. Was not planned. Certainly was not part of the show. I know you liked it, but
oh,
I sure did.
I liked it.
Well, I was damn mad about it, and I still am. And it won't happen again, I guarantee you. There'll be some people, I mean, find worse than they were. But Jackie Fargo got a little excited, that's fine. But he's coming back to make amends. And I tell you, he is going to take it to Jerry the King Lawler on July 10th. I tell you, there's so much action going on in this area. July 3rd, what a card. Bad Street Boys going for the tag belts along with New South in a three-way dance. Never had one of them before for a tag belt. Axel Rotten, a former ECW star, taking on Colorado Kid. I hear Savannah and her size 68 chest will be there.
St. Bernard's.
Yeah, to take with Farron Fox to take on the Prodigy, TJ Gray. Fan Lumberjack match. Now Lawler has something, and down goes the Colorado Kid.
There he goes, stuffing it back in his trunks. Lawler with that illegal object. Jimmy Rivers asking. Jimmy Rivers not too smart. Looking at the hands. Of course, he's going to hide it. Referee look. Bam, knocks the Colorado Kid back down to the mat. Close fist, I might add. Lawler in control of the Colorado Kid.
Tell you, I want to say hello to my good friend Ronnie P. Gossett there in Rossville, Georgia. I know he's watching today, and Ronnie, one of the greatest managers next to me that ever worked this area, and talked to Ronnie today, and he's doing good. I want to say hello to him. Also, all the great fans down in Loganville, Georgia, and Stockbridge, Georgia, and Canton. There's a drop kick by Lawler. He ain't done one of them since 1984. And great fans down in Georgia, and looking forward to coming to Stockbridge back later on tonight, where they see it down there every Sunday night in Stockbridge, Georgia, and Canton every Tuesday night, and Loganville every Thursday night. And boy, I tell you what, last Thursday night we was in Loganville, and Ernest T. tore the place apart. I mean, them people went nuts. It's Ernest T. mania in Loganville, Georgia.
They can
Thursday.
Have Ernest T. for all I care.
They
keep
want
him in Georgia.
They want
keep him away from me. Keep him away from the buttons, because Jeff is getting mad.
They want him.
I've seen
Jeff
picks up sticks ready to hit him every time he touches them buttons.
Ernest T. is a legend in Loganville. They loved him. And Bart Sawyer, just absolutely tore the place. There's Colorado Kid coming up from behind to Dundee. Count of one, count of two.
Only a two count. Stacy out there on the side in that little gold top that is so adorable.
Another reminder too, ladies and gentlemen. Sunday night, August 29th, pay-per-view from Las Vegas called Dangerous Curves. All women's wrestling pay-per-view.
Bubbies.
Be a lot more than just women's wrestling.
Oh.
And I'll be on there as Christopher Love, and it's going to be awesome. And Stacy's going to be a big part of that thing, Tom, along with some of the greatest lady wrestlers in the world called Dangerous Curves. Puppies galore. Sunday night, August 29th. Only on pay-per-view. So I want all you Nashville fans to watch and see how devious I can be with all the divas.
Yeah, you are devious. But hey, you know what? It's Mrs. Plaintiff's birthday today. Jerry the King Lawler in control of the Colorado Kid. Knee to the back of the head of the Colorado Kid. Still down. Stacy there cheerleading. I hope she don't lose her hair.
Happy birthday, Mrs. Plaintiff. I bet she got the same present she did the last 3 years.
Yep.
Okay, a knee to the back of the neck of the Colorado Kid.
Jerry Lawler now, you know, he's commentating for the WWF, doing, you know, just talking and stuff. But he can still wrestle. Lawler has still got some in it.
Yeah, but so does Jackie Fargo, and certainly the Colorado Kid does, who is ranked number one contender to the NWA World Belt, held by Naya Ogawa.
Now, if Colorado Kid ever gets the chance, that's going to be a match.
We're trying to sign that match.
He has every opportunity and the talent to win that belt from Ogawa.
He's got a big title defense coming out in Colorado Springs soon. We're going to try to sign that match with Ogawa. I tell you, Colorado Kid, in the last 2 weeks, we've had him booked in Texas, California, Florida. I mean, he's a wrestling champion.
There he just flips over Bill Dundee, and Lawler comes in for the save. Dundee back over on the Colorado Kid. One, two, finger to the eyes there by Jackie Fargo for the save.
All you fans also in Nashville that need a wrestling fix, they tell me my good friend Ronnie Crowder's running the show tonight in Carthage, Tennessee. I think it's at the Carthage Armory. Ronnie Crowder going to put an all-star card. You know, he's got a couple of no-name wrestlers, but most of the card's pretty legit. Over there in Carthage, if you want to see Farron Fox and Savannah and I guess Alcatraz probably on the card and a few others, check it out tonight in Carthage and say hello to Mr. Crowder. And there, I gave you a plug.
Look at that capacity crowd at the Fairground Sports Arena. Bert, that's the loudest crowd I've ever heard there.
They were loud that night and rowdy.
Jump
absolutely.
Puppies, we
but
want
can you
puppies.
Imagine? And remember, there's no increase in ticket prices. Can you imagine how packed that's going to be to see who gets their haircut, Fargo or Stacy, Saturday night, July 10th? Of course, Saturday, July 3rd, we're right back there with the Wim Bam Bim Bam card. And I'm telling you, ladies' night out, Bad Street Boys, New South, Colorado Kid, a dog collar chain match, fans lumberjack match, Bambi and Miss Angelica. Anything can happen
too.
In that one. Absolutely. TV title match. From top to bottom, one of the best cards. July's July shows are probably the hottest ever here in Nashville, and you can enjoy it in the air-conditioned comfort of the Nashville Fairgrounds Sports Arena.
Oh, yeah, that place is air-conditioned. Feels good in there.
Yes, it does.
Especially when it's hot outside. Jerry Lawler in control of the Colorado Kid. Comes up to the second rope. Going to jump off and do something here, pointing to him, trying to tip Jackie Fargo to come into the ring. Colorado Kid moves. Lawler, big mistake there. That's why they call it high risk. Just nails Bill Dundee. Flips over, and there's the tag to the Crazy One.
And this is a steaming hot tag to Fargo. Lawler's down, Dundee's down. Lawler's down, Dundee's down. You think he's got one more in him? What do you think? Jackie Fargo taking it to town on superstar Bill Dundee.
Well, atomic drop there on Dundee. Jimmy Rivers out of position. Jerry Lawler with the save.
If Lawler wasn't there, if Lawler was not in that ring, he'd have had that 1, 2, 3.
Well, there,
the big knee drop on Lawler. Come on, Fargo, come on.
1, 2, and a and three
Lawler,
count.
There you go.
Oh, there's Stacy.
Stacy's furious.
I want to be Jimmy Rivers. I want to be Jimmy Rivers, please.
Knock it off. They've got the 1, 2, 3. Stacy's furious at the referee. The referee weighs less than Stacy.
He's got Stacy up.
Oh, Fargo.
What?
Knock this off. Go to a break.
Go, Fargo.
No,
Fargo.
No.